Hey y'all, it's Lady C, and we are back. We missed Taco Tuesday, but I have been watching everybody with these nacho party packs from Taco Bell and looking so good. So me and the hubby been craving some nachos. So guess what? We're gonna do it our way, and ours always come out better, and you know this. But we got some Tostitos nachos. Well, I don't know, what do you call them? Tortillas. We got some romaine lettuce because I'm gonna do some vegetarian tacos with the romaine lettuce. I'm gonna show you guys how I do that. I've got some mini cucumbers, and I just wanted those anyway, so that's just for the house. I got some mild taco seasoning for my taco meat. Got some guacamole, because we're going to make that, cook that guacamole up. We got the avocados for the guacamole. We got some plum tomatoes to cut up. Yes. Yes, we had those tomatoes, y'all. I don't know whether I showed you. I did show you my Rotel. I'm going to make my dip with the Rotel. I always use this. This is the best. I've got the salsa con queso on deck. I only use Tostitos. It's the best kind. This is my personal choice. We've got the jalapeno peppers. Yes, hot sliced. We're gonna put those on our nachos. I want to use this in my veggie tacos. I'm gonna use the black beans and the in on my nachos. We've got some bananas because we love bananas around here. Some casera hot and some Herdy's salsa verde. I love salsa verde. And this is mild. Okay, so for some of the veggies we're going to use, you guys, hubby's working on it now, but I'm going to just step in on what he's doing. I use my crock pot to cook up my the stuff for my nachos, the ground turkey, the salsa con queso, and the Rotel. I put that all in my crock pot. You can see I love this crock pot, you guys, because the top has broken off and I'm still using it. I've got two other crock pots, but this is my favorite. So we're gonna make our veggie tacos using mushrooms. I saw someone do that, use the mushrooms as meat. I think it was Stephanie's 50 and Climbing. She had veggie tacos the other day, or veggie nachos, and she used mushrooms as the meat. I'm gonna use mushrooms because they kind of taste like meat, and I'm gonna season them up with some taco seasoning. I got a little pack of taco seasoning. I'm gonna season them up with that, give them some flavor. I'm gonna use some onion on my tacos and my nachos, and there's a fresh tomato for that. We're also gonna use some green pepper, cut that up and put them on both. So we should have a good thing going on. Hubby's got some green onion in the background going on that he's about to cut up. So I'll come back and show you guys how this all turns out. Talk to you later. All right, y'all. Basically, I cooked up the turkey meat in the pan, let it brown, and then you just follow the instructions on the taco seasoning packet. It basically says to add the whole package. This is McCormick. You add the entire package with 3/4 cup of water. You turn the heat down a little bit. Get that good flavor. Get the flavor of the taco seasoning in it. You basically cook it down till it gets thick. And then you're good to go. That means we're done with our taco meat as of now. I mean, I haven't let it thicken, but we're gonna let it thicken and then we're basically done with that part. Y'all, we're cutting up our green onion, and we can use these in either the veggie tacos or the nachos. It's your own choice, but we love green onion around here, and it's so cheap. If you go out and purchase it in the Asian markets, you can get a lot of it for like nothing. All right, you guys, I am back. Our meat is done. I let it saute. Now I'll put the meat in the crock pot with all the juice. You want it to have all that good juice, so it'll still have all that good flavor. Sound like Lady T. on the flavor train. If y'all know anything about Lady T, you need to get to her channel. Love to watch her. Flavor train be moving it. So you got your turkey meat or beef or whatever you want to put in there. I prefer turkey meat. You've got it seasoned with your taco seasoning. Now you're going to add the one can of the Rotel. I use mild to give it a little kick. You could use spicy if you want to kick it up a notch. Or you can add hot sauce or whatever you want to do. This is what I do. Just mix it on in there. And you know, doing it in the crock pot, it just gives it so much flavor because everything gets to mix and meld around. You let it cook up for a while, give it that good flavor, and you just, oh, it's just a happy time. My kids love this. They've been loving it since they were little. All right, you guys, I'm back. We put the Rotel in it, and we've got it on our crock pot. Now we have added our salsa con queso, Tostitos, the best, made with real cheese. You see that? So we got that. We've put it on the crock pot. We're going to put this on. I normally put it on low if you're not in a rush to eat, which I'm really not right now. All my children are not here. My husband just got home from work. I mean, we'll be okay. All right, we ain't starving. So you can put it on high if you want it to be done faster. And it's basically done. Your meat is cooked. You just add in your ingredients. I like it to go in the crock pot just to get everything to meld together. If you want to season it up more, you can do that. This is the only way I do it. I don't put anything else in it. I put this on. Let me make sure I can't see. My crock pot is so old, you guys. I want you to see how old. It's so old you cannot read the letters off of this. I love my crock pot. But anyway, everything's in here. It's ready to go. I don't have the top, but I'll get the top. Right. And then, as I told you, it's so old, I have broken the top off of it. I just love my crock pot. I got two brand new crock pots. But I continue to use this one. Anyway, so we're ready, you guys. Once you do that, you're ready. You let it cook up. And then you're just going to basically use it to pour over your nachos and put all your other ingredients on it. And we're going to do our vegetarian nachos, and we're going to show you guys those in the end, how that comes out. Talk to you guys later. Love you. Bye-bye. Here's some of our veggies, you guys. Hubby's putting a tomato on there. You know, when you do it like this, it's just so much easier. I'm not a chopper. I will do it if he's not available to do it. But my husband is so much of a better chopper that I, you know, always ask him to chop up the veggies. Because they always come out, I don't know, better. And it's faster. I'd probably chop my hand off or something like that. I don't care what he do, y'all. As long as he keep that wedding ring on. Yeah, boy. But yeah, so that's how that's going to go down. We're going to continue chopping, and I'll show you guys the end result later. Bye-bye.
Probo.
Ooh, y'all, there's the cut-up, there's the cut-up mushrooms, and we've got some cashews in here. We've got taco seasoning, so this is going to be for our vegetarian tacos, you guys. Got our black beans, and we got our refried beans. Here's my vegetarian taco. Yes, 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 yes. You guys saw how I made it. And here is my turkey meat nachos. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Hey, y'all. It's Lady C, and we are in the place to be. Excuse my headwear, although I do love the Ravens. Hubby and I just did that raw egg challenge, and we did it with no problem. So yeah, we handled that. I had my Raven's headgear on and didn't feel like taking this off because I will have to comb my hair. Therefore, we're gonna hang out with the hat tonight. It's all good. Still can't resist me. I want to show you guys the vegan nachos that we made. Look at that, y'all. Yes, I'm showing everything. Look at them jalapenos. Ooh. Yes, got guacamole on there. Some sour cream. Romaine lettuce. Got a little bit of fried beans on the side. That is something special. I don't have my setup tonight, so I'm holding everything up so you guys can see. And I just want to take a few bites because my battery is now low. My fault. These are not the veggies. These are the regular ones, you guys. This is turkey meat, black bean, guacamole, tomato, green onion, green pepper. Oh, sour cream. This is the bomb. I will hold it up. I don't know when the battery's gonna go out. I want to give you guys an idea of that. Look at that. Black bean. Take a bite. I've been watching all y'all eat nachos all week long. Crunch them on them Taco Bell. Mine are better. Jalapenos got it going on, y'all. I'm giving y'all a few minutes now, because my phone is going to die. One day I'll be like the big wigs, have me a camera. Ooh, these black beans are so good. Look at that, y'all. Switch it up and give y'all a little bit of veggie. I was inspired for the veggie by Stephanie's 50 and Climbing. She made something similar. And I made these with sauteed mushroom and peanut and cashews. Also, anything else you could find to put on them. The only thing is I didn't put so much on here. I can't pick it up. Y'all can get the general idea. I gotta eat some of it with a fork. It's good. If I was a vegetarian, we'd be rolling, y'all. But I'm only cut myself back to chicken and turkey. Not a vegetarian right now. I'm just not trying to eat that pork and trying to eat that beef. And fish. Oh, I'm sorry. I always said chicken and turkey, but I also eat fish. Ooh, y'all. Let me see if I, oh, Laura. Every time I try to pick it up, it's going back down. So, for now, I'll try to give y'all the idea. It's good. Try to fix it so y'all can get an idea. My own fault because I put too much on here. But it's so good. Well, I picked it up a little bit. Mm. Mm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, bit, baby, look. You ain't tasted yet?
Oh, I had one already.
Yeah,
really good.
I sauteed the mushrooms and taco season, so you still could get the general flavor without the meat. Mm. I might come up with some other things. And tonight I'm sipping on some sparkling ice peach nectarine. Y'all, I didn't eat so fast. I didn't say my grace. Lord, please bless the food that I've eaten, because I should have said my grace. And Lord, bless everything that we're eating tonight. Bless all my subscribers, Lord, new and old. Bless all my family, and let us just walk in the manner that you would have us walk. Amen. Whew. Yeah, I did that. Lord, I did the raw egg challenge. Posted that yesterday. The regular nachos is good too with this turkey meat, y'all. Oh my God. Can't go wrong with turkey meat. You can get it as lean as you want. You know, in the store, how they have the 85%, 95%, however lean you want it. And it doesn't have a lot of grease on it. You'll notice when you cook turkey meat, you do not get a lot of grease. I love that. You just get good juice. Anyway, I just want to come share my nachos with y'all. Show you that you don't got to buy them from a restaurant for them to be good. You can make them yourself. Share me out, y'all. I love each and every single solitary one of y'all for watching. I have guacamole, though. Talk to y'all in the next mukbang. Love y'all. Good night.